On today's Grandma Thelma Tuesday.
Well,
right, Grandma Thelma, introduce yourself.
She calls me when I'm recording.
Not really. I'm adopted by Chava. I have 7 grandchildren of my own, and I love them all. I love Chava also. And I love joining her every Tuesday. Now, she asked me to write a poem. I don't know if I'm such a good poet writer, but I say what I think in the poem. So this is my poem. It has to do with money. It's important to start a stake if it's a lot of money you want to make. But even a small retirement plan will help you as much as it can. Even if you start today, save some money is all I say. What happened, Chava?
Oh, it's okay. My phone, the alarm went for 2:30 to call you, so it's okay.
It's good to have a little stash of something that can give you cash. Because there's always something to buy, it's good to give saving a try. Expenses keep going greater, so the more assets you have, it'll help you later. We'll make you happy and serene. That's why they call me the queen.
Ooh, Grandma Thelma, I love that one. That one's so much better than last week. No offense. I love this one, Grandma Thelma. But you know what? As my grandmother says, my biological grandmother says, I just don't have saving money in my bones. I can't marry someone who's stingy. What's the difference between being stingy and saving money?
Who says that about you? Does she say it?
She says, because I went out with guys, Grandma Thelma, that they were so worried about, like, the dollar, having discounts, all of this stuff. My grandmother said I couldn't marry someone like that because we'd always have fights about money.
Well, you know what? Sometimes you have to overlook things. You have to do your things and they do their things. Because sometimes it keeps you... If you're both the same way about money, that makes it even worse because you just spend money. If one knows how to save and one knows how to spend, so at least if he's saving, you'll have money to spend.
Exactly. Well, how was your relationship with your husband? Who was the spender and who was the saver?
If anything, I was the saver, but he didn't... He made the money, and I was the one that invested the money and took care of the money.
Exactly. That's how it is in every home. My mom's a spender and money tracker, and my dad's just there to make the money. That's the point of the husband, Grandma Thelma. They just give you all the money, and you do whatever you want. But with responsibility, though, because I didn't tell you this, but my brother, he went to the Burberry store, and they advertised that the stuff's made in England, and the shirt was $347, and guess where it was made?
In China.
In Vietnam. It wasn't even handmade. It was just a white shirt with the words Burberry, so... Obviously.
Well, see, that's what makes it so unfair, because they had the names. Originally, Burberry was all made in England, but they found out that they have these Asian countries where people get low salaries and they can make things much cheaper.
Right, so I realized it's kind of like saving money. I mean, I still spend money, but I get more for my money. You know what I mean? Because
but
in
time... But you try to get value for your money.
Exactly. So what's the difference between saving and value?
Well, says that's what you do. Look, usually you have a certain amount of money that you earn, and you put it in little piles. A certain amount is for spending, where you try to get your best value. A certain amount is for saving. Some is for save, for spending on things you must have every day.
That's essential.
Then you have a discretionary fund that you can have fun with and do whatever you want with the money. That's when you have extra money.
Mm. I used to do that when I was a babysitter. I think I was more like a nanny. I think I was making $1,608. But don't get me on tax fraud. I don't pay my taxes. Maybe I should edit this out for tax fraud. But no, I think I made less than $10,000, so I don't have to pay taxes, actually. So it's okay. Or I'll ask your brother to file my taxes.
My brother alone. He has enough.
So, basically, I made tons of money. But I ended up having like $300 I could play with. I have this obsession, Grandma Thelma. Should I show you my obsession?
What is your obsession? Is that the Doge coins?
No. So I have this crazy obsession with money. I know, it's probably really unhealthy. And no one on the YouTube channel think I'm a millionaire because I'm not. But I'll show you. I put some money in the bank because my grandmother says it makes interest, so it's not good to have cash. But look at this, Grandma Thelma. I have a $1 bill.
Yes.
I have a $2 bill.
Yes.
And
a $5 bill.
What?
A $5 bill.
Yeah, I have a $5 bill. Then, hold on a second. Then I have a $10 bill.
Now, is that those bills for spending or saving?
No, it's just...
For security.
No, it's just because I love having this money. I don't do any... I'll never use it. Then I have a $20 bill.
Well, you remind me of somebody we know that never uses any of his money.
Oh, I use money. I love money.
We're not naming any names.
But we all know. Then I have a 50. That's so beautiful. I love how 50s look. And then, of course...
Well, one thing, you live a very comfortable life. I see you don't deny yourself anything.
Exactly. And I have a $100 bill.
Is that the highest?
Yeah, because they don't give out $1,000 bills anymore. I really want a $1,000 bill. But they stopped making them because now people use credit cards and it's not like so easy. Even the $2 bill, I got it because I went to this person's wedding and her grandfather was giving out to her friends $2 bills. So then I was like, oh my God, this is what I need to fulfill my collection. But then I have a couple more sets of it because I just love keeping all this money. But I don't use it, I just stare at it sometimes. It makes me feel good about myself.
Well, in a way that's good, so you know you have that much money.
Yeah, but I put some because I invested in Dogecoin, and I won't say because Yosef says it's not good to boast. So I won't.
Right, and every day is a different day.
Exactly. So I think, you know, I always look on Google, Grandma Thelma, how long would it take someone to become a millionaire? If you put like $10 a day for like 25 years or something like that, so that make me like 45, 46 years old, I could become a millionaireess.
Well, first of all, at that time, I hope you'll be married and have children.
Oh, that's true. So then I'll have to be a little more, less spending, maybe.
Maybe you'll have it, depends who you marry.
Exactly. Oh, I don't know if you can see Betty in the background. But you know what, Grandma Thelma? I think the most important thing is, like, people should know, like, they should use their credit cards and know how to get money back on it. You know what I mean? Like, cash rewards.
I know it, but you have to spend money to get the cash rewards.
Right, right. So I learned about this like maybe 2 years ago, and also how to get miles. When even if you spend like $45, at least you get mileages on the airline companies. So then I'm learning how to be spending money, but gaining money back too.
Yeah, well, those are small amounts.
Yeah, it's good. Do you have any advice for people? How to save money or be
advice. First of all, whatever you need, you have to do for yourself. You can't be that you don't spend on yourself what you need.
Bless you. Even May sneezed on the truth.
Because you yourself are the most important person to you. But you can't go in debt because
Talking about debt, Grandma Thelma? That's why I don't date anyone with any student loans or credit card debt. Because it's good that people have good credit scores. I'm going to flex right now. Yosef says, my credit score is 781.
Yeah, because you listen, you're lucky that your parents, your mother and father are very good to you.
I know. They spoil me. Means my husband's going to have a lot of trouble. He's gonna
what did your aunt, your grandma say?
For what?
The grandma that lives near you.
Oh, she says that I'm lucky and I should be so grateful because not everyone has such a kind family that I have.
I agree with her.
And that, you know,
well, you know, a lot of times she and I say the same things.
You know, I think it's a generational thing.
Of course, it is a generational thing, because every generation thinks that were born, people that were born in my generation watch much more because we had so little, and we're glad that times changed, and then we didn't have to really worry about money anymore.
Right, were you born in the Great Depression times?
I was born in 1930. The Depression was from 1929 to about 1940, till the war started. So I was born during the Depression.
And that's why you're able to understand the value of money. Because this generation doesn't know what it means. Like, what's the value of a dollar? What's the value of $10? You know what I mean?
Well, look, I hope that everything stays the same because otherwise sometimes things change in a person's life. And a lot has to do with luck because let's not kid ourselves. Some people are luckier than others.
Exactly. But you know, Yosef was saying yesterday, he doesn't like when I dish out his laundry, but he said one of his friends, his dad, owns 4 rehab companies, and so he says he wishes my dad wasn't a rabbi in the army and did like investment and like big.
Well, I got you can own 4 rehab companies, and then something can happen, and then they go in debt, and you can lose all the companies too. That's happened also.
Do you know people that were put in a situation like that?
Of course, I know people that did that. There were people that were millionaires and became paupers, and paupers that became millionaires.
Oh, so it's like the circle of life then. My grandmother says the Yiddish expression, Geld ist kalichdik.
Geld ist what?
Kalichdik, it's round.
And it's circular and it goes around.
But the thing is, they even have on Netflix called Schitt's Creek, and it's about...
Yes, I watched it. That's right. They had a lot of money, and then they lost their money.
And all they had was a town left because they went to the wrong person.
That's right. So nobody knows what can happen. So that's why you can't say you wish you had that. Whatever you have to work for. And I'm sure even the ones that has 4 rehabs, he didn't get it by not working for them.
Exactly, but his son gets to inherit everything. So that's what Yosef was upset about.
His son gets to inherit, but if he doesn't watch it good, he can lose everything also.
Exactly. Well, Grandma Thelma, our 15 minutes are up.
Oh, it went so fast today.
I know, because it's such a good topic. Is there any last closing words you want to share with the YouTube subscribers?
I hope every one of you invest your money, and whatever you invest in goes up, 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 and you all make a lot of money.
Amen. And stay puff, puff, positive. We'll see you guys next.